Hello students, how are you? I hope that you all will be fine staying home and doing study at your home and doing creative works also. On the behalf of Paramount Public School, today we are going to discuss summary of our first chapter of book Hornbill, and the name of the chapter is The Portrait of a Lady. Without wasting our time, let's move to our topic. The Portrait of a Lady. It's written by Khushwant Singh. The Portrait of a Lady is written in first person and is in biographical mode. In this story, the writer gives a detailed account of his grandmother, with whom he had a long association. It means that Khushwant Singh is describing his relationship with his grandmother while residing with her. Khushwant Singh recalls his grandmother as a short, fat, and slightly bent. Her silver hair was scattered untidily on her wrinkled face. Here the physical appearance of grandmother is described. She hobbled around the house in white clothes, with one hand resting on her waist. Why she kept her one hand on the waist? To balance her stoop, and the other tilling the beads of her rosary. That is our description of grandmother. Then Khushwant Singh remembers her as not very pretty, but always beautiful. She was not pretty, but was charming. He compares her serene face to that of a winter landscape. During their long stay in the village, grandmother, walking up in the morning, plastered his wooden slate, which he used to carry in the school, prepared his breakfast and escorted him to school. It means grandmother also went to school with the author. While he studied alphabets, she read the scriptures in the temple attached to the school. Scriptures means holy books. In their way back home, she fed steel chapatis to stray dogs also. Stray dogs means dogs we find in our street. The turning point in their relationship came when they went to live in the city. As students, I want to tell you here that parents of Khushwant Singh left him in the village and went to the city to settle themselves in the city. When they got settled in a better way, then they call both grandmother and Khushwant Singh. Now, the author went to a city school in a motor bus and studied English, law of gravity, Archimedes principle, and many more things which he could not understand at all. And in the village, while he learns alphabet, grandmother helped him in his studies. But here he is learning English language and some different science, math, in which grandmother could not help because she couldn't understand these things. Grandmother could no longer accompany him to school nor help him in his studies. Now she couldn't go to accompany him into school because the author went to school by bus. She was upset that there was no teaching of God and scriptures at city school. Instead, he was given music lesson, which was, according to her, was not meant for gentle folk. It means grandmother thought that music is not for the gentle people, normal people. It is a monopoly of harlots. Harlot means beggars. But she said nothing. When Khushwant Singh went to a university now, he was given a separate room. The common link of their friendship was snapped. Snapped mean finished. It means that while they come from the village, they used to share a single room there. Grandmother rarely talked to anyone now. She spent most of her time sitting beside her spinning wheel, reciting prayers and feeding the sparrows in the afternoon. Now, when the author left for abroad, grandmother didn't get disturbed. Rather, she saw him off at the railway station. Seeing her old age now, the narrator thought that it was his last meeting with his grandmother. Last meeting with her. But contrary, in opposite to his thinking, when he returned after a span of 5 years, grandmother was there to receive him also. She celebrated the occasion by singing songs of the homecoming of warriors on an old dupilated drum. Dupilated means, it means a drum of iron or some other mixture. Dupilated drum. Along with the ladies of the neighborhood. Then what happened when she was happy? Next morning, she got ill. Although the doctor said that it was a mild fever and would go away soon, she could foresee that her end was near. She didn't want to waste time talking to anyone. So she lay peacefully in bed, praying and telling the beads of her rosary till her lips stopped moving and the rosary fell from her lifeless fingers. Now, grandmother got tired. To mourn her death, thousands of sparrows flew in the room and sat scattered around her body. There was no chirping, and when Khushwant Singh's mother threw them breadcrumbs to the sparrows, they took no notice of the bread also. They flew away quietly. When the dead body of grandmother was carried away for last rites, they all, even the sparrows, were feeling sad at the death of grandmother. So come to the conclusion of this summary is, to sum up the portrait of a lady summary, the writer and his grandmother had a beautiful bond between them and loved each other a lot. The story tells us how beautiful a relationship can become between a grandson and his grandmother. I hope, students, you got the summary very well. And the story of the chapter same also. Thank you. Thanks for watching.